Darmi managed by our matchmaker Terry Tall. Nice left hand there from Harry. And I'm afraid this is the first time I've seen Paul Miles box. I haven't a clue who his manager is. I should have found out. I do apologise. Once again, a good jab from Darmi. And he could probably control this fight all night long behind that long left hand of his. As you can see, he's very tall, 6'1 or 2. Checking Miles' record, the other named loss on there was that of Derek Roach from Leeds. I've got a feeling that Miles will need to do more than just box Darmi here. He's going to have to be real aggressive, try and get underneath those long arms. And of course, if he stands back like this, he'll get his head picked off all night. Well, that's a pretty reasonable start, I'd say, for Harry Darmi. No shocks or problems to deal with there, I don't think. And this one going at the moment the way I anticipated. No offence, of course, to Paul Miles from Walton. Also fought in Finland. Miles against Jari Kjell, who, of course, was the... whatever he was a top-class amateur. A couple of wins, though, for Miles worth mentioning. Danny Quaker and Darren Coville. Two bangers, and he got through those okay. So this one could be 10 rounds. And four losses on the trot for Darmi against good men. Clay O'Shea, Robert Wright, Johnny Bosco, and Nicky Thurbin. But in his own class, he's okay.
10 seconds. Really? Seconds up,
so into round two then. Was that a left hook from Harry Darmi, I wonder? I think it probably was. Ian John Lewis, well, he bounced straight up, and there's already a mark now underneath the left eye of Miles here. Well, I was just distracted for a second there and missed that punch as it landed. It could well have been, in fact, I'd say it was a right. That's landed on the left eye of Miles, because that's come up badly now and it's swelling by the second. Once again, lovely punches from Darmi, and well, Miles might be finished here. Well, the eye is still gone, and Ian John Lewis is just checking in, giving him one more opportunity, but I think the card has been marked now for Paul Miles. He's been over twice and that left eye is closing rapidly. So it looks like a second successful defence of the Southern Area Championship for Harry Darmi. Quite a lackadaisical kind of approach, Darmi, but it's pretty effective. again that right catches Miles. Miles now forced to hang on. And I've got a feeling the former... Oh, nice right from Miles. Just out about to say that Miles is on borrowed time. Oh, he comes out with two crunching rights. But four marks to Dami. He's taken them well. Once again, Miles rattled there. Again, a stiff left hand from Paul Miles. Well, this one's looking very interesting now. Two right hands from Harry Dami have dumped Miles on the floor. Miles got up. The left eye is looking bad, but Miles crunched in a couple of... and Miles has gone to the wrong corner there. Well, that's going to be a 10-9 round, without a doubt. For Dami, and possibly 10-8 and a half in fact, but two good rights I thought from Paul Miles, and they're having a look at the eye. It might all be over here. It's all over. What a shame. Well, referee John Lewis has gone there to have a chat with the corner, but it looks like Miles' challenge is finished. They're saying there's not a great deal of point going on, the eye is too bad. It's all over. So it's all over. Harry Dami retains his Southern Area welterweight title for the second time at the end of round two. And that's an awful shame for Paul Miles. He showed a great deal of grit and courage to come back and crack Dami with a couple of good right hands, having taken two knockdowns and suffered a badly swollen and still swelling left eye. Well, there you see it. You can't fight with one left eye or with one eye, I'm afraid. Here we are again, bit of replay. Just see how this one occurred. Is this the first knockdown? Bang, yes it was. Or was that the second knockdown? So here we go then for our official results.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of round two, Paul Miles unfortunately retired due to a badly damaged left eye. Your winner and still the welterweight champion, Harry Dami.
So there he is then, Harry Dami, very happy winner here. Gets his arm raised by our referee, Ian John Lewis. As I say, he retains his Southern Area welterweight crown for the second time. Bad luck, Paul Miles. But what can you do? You can't legislate for that kind of injury as Roy Brown puts the belt around the waist of the champion. So there you are then, Harry Dami is the winner. Well, it'll be interesting to have a word with Ian John Lewis later on and just see if that was in fact a corner retirement or a referee stoppage or... There was a bit of a conflict between them by the look of things, so it looks like a joint agreement, referee and corner man. Anyway, we're going to take another short break. Our joint main event, Johnny Armour, is coming up.